So, this is it, huh?
I hope I don't get lost.
Can you all hear me?
Whoa! Is that you, Senpai?
I'll be providing audio backup from here on out.
Wait, you mean you can see inside here?
It's my persona's ability. I'd like to join you, but the structure of Tartarus changes from day to day. That's why outside support is imperative.
Well, that makes me feel a whole lot better.
Now, based on your current location, you can expect to encounter enemies at any minute. They shouldn't be too tough, but proceed with caution. Practice makes perfect.
Right!
Got it. Why is she always like that?
Has informed me about your power, but nevertheless, you have minimal combat experience. Would you like me to explain the basics of battle? The primary offensive options available to you in battle are attack and skill. Attack corresponds to the weapon you've equipped, while skill relates to your persona's abilities. Though skills consume either stamina or spiritual power, they tend to have a greater effect. Use whichever option best suits the situation. Keep attacking until you've defeated the enemy, but pay careful attention to your stamina. That's it for now. Did you get all that? Okay, then I want you to defeat the enemy before you. Try using both the skill and attack options. You exploited the enemy's weakness.
Here's a chance. Let's get him!
Get back here, you son of a...
What a stunning victory!
Time for me to explain about attack properties, which are important to consider during battle. Do you want to know more? Nearly every type of attack is associated with a particular property. For example, swords can be used to do slash attacks, while bows are used to do pierce attacks. Skills, on the other hand, have different properties. Bufu, for instance, indicates an ice attack. Now, most enemies are vulnerable to certain types of attacks. In other words, they have weaknesses. A fire skill will deal greater damage to an enemy that's weak against fire. With my power, I can analyze an enemy to determine its weaknesses and strengths. That falls under tactics. Yeah. You follow? The enemies you're facing have a weakness that you can exploit. Why don't you give it a try?
Roger. I'll attempt to analyze the enemy.
Can't lose. Damn. I couldn't finish it off.
Talk about it. The enemy's weakness is fire. Just one more. A wisely chosen attack.
Here's our chance. Let's get him. Get back here, you scum!
A complete victory. Great job.
Were you able to exploit the enemy's weakness in the last battle? If you didn't already notice, doing so will also grant you an additional attack. Would you like more details? An enemy will lose its balance if you exploit its weakness or land a critical hit. This will give you the opportunity to perform an additional action. In other words, you'll get to do one more thing. You can keep attacking the same enemy, or if you prefer, attack a different target. And if you succeed in knocking another enemy off balance, then you can act yet again. Which means you can remain on the offensive for as long as you can keep this up. This strategy is essential to securing victory. However, remember this. An enemy that's already lost its balance cannot be knocked off balance again. You can't knock down someone who's lying on the ground, right? It's the same idea. Now, to knock an enemy off balance, you need to know its weaknesses. So don't hesitate to ask me for an analysis. I'll be sure to share the results with the others as well. Got it? Then proceed with the battle. Use what you've learned to quickly dispose of the enemy.
The enemy's weakness! Yes, the enemy is vulnerable. Attack! The enemy is vulnerable. Keep going! Attack again! Here's our chance for an all-out attack! Throw me at him!
You have the potential to grow even stronger.
My skill level has increased!
Ta-da-da-da! Junpei is leveled up!
Thank you.
There is a better way to defeat all of your enemies in battle than to attack them individually. You can perform an all-out attack. Would you care to hear more about this? When enemies are thrown off balance, they become vulnerable. An all-out attack will allow your entire team to attack simultaneously. Your enemies will be unable to defend against it. It's a very reliable method of attack. Whether or not you want to perform an all-out attack is up to you. But remember, you cannot perform it when you're alone. So if you want to have it in your arsenal, make sure your team is comprised of at least two members. That's all you need to know about all-out attacks. Do you understand what I've just explained to you? Then, that concludes the basics of battle. But there's one last thing I need to tell you. Shadows become stronger the further you advance. If you don't think you can win a battle, retreat at once. There may be times, however, when an escape will be impossible. This battle is one of those times. Good luck.
The enemy's weakness is fire. A wisely chosen attack. Yes, the enemy is vulnerable. Attack. You struck the enemy's weak spot.
Get out!
The enemy is vulnerable. Keep going.
Here's our chance for an all-out attack. Ready, Adam.
Keep up the good work.
Yes! My skill level has increased!
Ta-da-da-da! I'm the man!
Everyone, spread out and proceed individually.
Okay, then I'll look around some more.
Everyone, return to the leader.
Oh.